This is Dr. Pawluk. In a previous video, I introduced the idea of the importance of the intensity of the magnetic field needed for magnetic field therapy to give the best results. This video now goes into more detail about the intensity needed to treat inflammation. PEMFs have long been found to help with inflammation and tissue repair and regeneration. It is now known that much of this action of PEMFs against inflammation is done by stimulating a molecule in the body called adenosine and its cellular adenosine receptors. Recent PEMF research found that there is an optimum PEMF intensity needed to stimulate the adenosine receptors on the white blood cells. These are the primary immune cells used by the body to combat inflammation. Adenosine is considered the guardian angel of the tissues of the body to protect against runaway inflammation. PEMFs increase adenosine throughout the body. Adenosine is needed to produce and release ATP from the mitochondria of cells. ATP is the major source of energy in body tissues. As inflammation anywhere in the body increases, a major increase in ATP is needed to control it. In chronic inflammation, the tissues often cannot produce enough ATP. As a result, inflammation persists, damaging tissues and impairing bodily functions. So, what is the optimum PEMF intensity required? 1.5 millitesla, or 15 Gauss, is the optimal intensity at the adenosine receptor on the white blood cell. Since inflammation can happen anywhere in the body, the starting intensity of the magnetic field required to combat inflammation needs to be considered to give 15 Gauss at whatever depth the tissues are that need treatment. Since magnetic field intensity drops off very rapidly, as the field leaves the source of the magnetic field, the intensity the magnetic field produced has to be considered or calculated based on the depth of the treated tissue. As an example, if the kidneys are being treated, the depth and the size of the kidneys needs to be considered. In an average person, the magnetic field has to achieve 15 Gauss at about 4 inches or 10 centimeters into the body. That means the starting magnetic field needs to be about 1820 Gauss. This same type of calculation needs to be done anytime the body is being treated with a PEMF. There's a table in a blog on drpawluk.com that gives these numbers. The blog is called PEMFs, the Guardian, Angel, Adenosine, and Inflammation. From this table, you will know what the starting magnetic field needs to be. It is possible that weaker magnetic fields than the optimal may still have value deep in the body, but in my experience, results are less predictable and may take longer, because less adenosine is being produced. Thank you for watching. Dr. Pawluk, all the best.